Hi, my name is Tony Morrow, and in today's episode of Getting Hired, we'll be talking about skills and endorsements and recommendations. Coming right up. Welcome, everybody. My name is Tony Morrow, and this is Getting Hired, the show that is helping you, the military member, successfully transition from your military career to your new civilian one. In today's episode, we're going to talk about LinkedIn. In the third episode in this series, we're going to specifically talk about two things. One, recommendations. And endorsements. Let's dive right into it. As with our previous episodes, we're going to go into our settings to make sure that nothing we change is going to be automatically updated to our network. So we're going to go into privacy settings, sharing profile edits, and click this to know. Skills and endorsements are a key opportunity for you to be able to align industry terminology and skill sets that you have experience with on your profile. If you want to be able to add a new specific skill, click on Add a New Skill. And here you can see, you can begin to put in social media. Here you can see it makes recommendations on specific skills that are recommended within the LinkedIn profile. Social media optimization, social media communications, social media measurement, and so on. For the purposes of this exercise, we're going to pick social media communications. Now I've added this, and you can see that in the top three here, it's not listed. If you want to change the order of specific skills listed in your skill set, hit the pencil button and then go over to what we previously identified in another video, the hamburger menu, or basically the stacked lines in the corner. Once you click on that, you can move your different skills to highlight your top three. Now, your top three should be the ones that either best apply to the role, position, or industry that you're looking to move into, or be the skill sets that you are the most experienced and have the most endorsements for. Once you have a skill, for example, on my profile, podcasting, you have a number of individuals that you are connected to in your network that can endorse you for that skill. The more endorsements you have, the better. And ideally, you want to have 20 or more, or as many as you can, endorsements on any particular skill. Once you have over 99, it'll list 99 plus. Although you may have more endorsements, you won't show any more endorsements other than the 99 listed in your profile. As you can see by my profile here, this is a critical weakness in my LinkedIn profile in that I need to solicit more endorsements on my various skills. Now you can do this by asking for endorsements from the connections in your network, and it can either be a tit for tat in the sense that I'll endorse you for this if you'll endorse me for that and so on, or you can just reach out to your connections and ask them to endorse you for skills that they've seen or have experience with you exercising. Now the second part is recommendations, and recommendations stand out from the endorsements in that the endorsements are acknowledgement of tags, keywords that you are using on your profile that are provided essentially by LinkedIn. You identify it through the settings as we just laid out in LinkedIn, and then other people can interact with your profile and just acknowledge that you have that particular identified skill. When it comes to recommendations, it's a much more personal and in-depth request. If you are looking to get a recommendation, you would click on Add Profile section, scroll down to Additional Information, and request a recommendation. Who do I want to ask? Elder. So what's my relationship with Elder? You pick the relationship that applies to you. So for the purposes here, we're going to say you worked with Elder in the same group and select your position, averagefather.com. Now in this section here, you can write a more personalized note of what it is you're asking for in the recommendation. So just like in your resume, you have references or references upon request, this section allows for people that you know in your network to write you a recommendation you can display on your LinkedIn profile. And this essentially offers the validation, the social support, whatever the skill sets or the value that you bring, and highlight that unique point of value for your profile. So to prove the value of endorsements and recommendations, I have a challenge for you, LinkedIn. If you're watching this on YouTube, then head over to LinkedIn. And if you're on LinkedIn, then click my profile so that we can connect. If we're already connected, then go ahead, click my picture on this article, connect with me, and then go down to the skills and endorsements section. Click on the plus button next to the specific skill and give me an endorsement. Let's see how fast that we can get the social media communication skill up to 99. If you found value in today's video, then please hit the like button on LinkedIn and on YouTube. If you're watching on YouTube, then please consider subscribing and hit the bell notification so that you can stay up to date on all the latest videos coming from Getting to Hired. If you're on LinkedIn, then consider sharing this video with anybody and everybody who you think would find value from today's content. Looking forward to seeing you next week on Wednesday. And don't forget about this Friday for the live stream Sliders at 3 o'clock Pacific time. I'll see you then. Bye for now.